Hello everyone, this is a Crazy back with another deck review. And today I have the remaining colors of the Magic Notebook decks that were from Pokeball Point Guards. They came out last year. Initially they released mainly just black and blue, sky blue as it is, decks. And I got those and I reviewed them. And they're fairly simple, fairly straightforward. They just kind of look like NLC decks. And I wasn't planning on getting the rest, but you know what, I said, screw it, I want the complete set, so I did. Initially in that video, I think I said that there was 10 colors total, but actually it's only 8, thankfully. And these are the remaining colors. You get red, white, pink, champagne, orange, and green, although it's a really kind of a light green color. The final talk case says, be natural. What I mean by this is, be yourself. It's a quote by Di Vernon, apparently, and it's a very good piece of advice for whatever you're doing. always be yourself. On the one side says Spring Series 2016 Limited Magic Notebook. The other side, nothing, but it's a different color. Top says Magician Liu Xiao. It seems like each one is made for a different magician. That one's that one. This one is Jackie Sun. This one is Fu Kieng, probably butchering his names. This one is Super Ning. This one is Richard Mo. And this one is Wang Yu. So all Asian. The bottoms, he's got some logos. That says Master Edition, Pokeball Point Guard. The backs, they mainly just say Pokeball Point Guard Company on the bottom. Kind of hard to read. But this one actually has a logo for Ning. I think Ning is actually the magic babe. That makes sense, it's a full element. Very interesting. I'll just show you all the different colors. Nothing on the flaps, just standard tough cases. You get some ad cards. I won't cover them. This one is black on one side, so you can always be used as a cut card if you want. And the other one's got Japanese on it. Go to get these ad cards, the Pokeball ad cards, which is a big B. One's in red and the other one is in blue. And the Ace of Spades. It is a simple spade, but it says Pokeball Playing Card Company on the bottom, and it's in a nice green color. Everything else is completely standard. And the back is in a light, very light green. With a green border. It's very similar to the blue one. The blue one is slightly different in color, obviously, and it has a gold border, if I recall correctly. The orange one you get the same ad cards. And orange spade pip, and the back's also orange with like a red border. The champagne is next. Same ad cards. The spade pip is kind of a, I don't know, a tan color or gold color. And the backs are in a yellowy color with a gold border. Kind of reminds me of the color of gingerella or something. Champagne, I guess. Next is the red one. Same ad cards again. This one has a spade pip, and you guessed it, red. And the backs are red with a gold border. Very similar to NLCs. No jokers. You can actually use those two Pokeball ad cards as jokers if you really need. Not a big deal. Next is the white one. Same ad cards. And this one has a spade pip and a slightly yellowy color. Oh. And the backs are white with a gold border. And lastly, the pink one, the Magic Babe. Or whatever her name is. Ning. Same ad cards. The Ace of Spades, of course, is pink. And the backs are pink with a kind of a dark pink border. Very nice, colorful. You can check out my review on the blue and black ones as well if you want. Definitely different colors than the NOCs, like that one obviously. That's a bit different. Pink, there was never any pink NOCs for some reason, but it is what it is. I don't recall which decks, like which magicians the black and the blue ones were for. It's a, I believe these are actually on a B stock, B casino stock, Ericus and Finis, not I recall. So it's a good stock in Finis. And now I'm going to tell you exactly where those aces are. I'm going to count down to them, tell you the exact number. No, forget it. I'm just kidding. I don't know where they are. So they handle pretty good. Nice colors, as you can see. Like I said, B-Stock and Ericus and Finis. And I don't remember the exact price point, but they're not overly expensive. You can still get these six colors from Collectible Playing Cards while quantities remain. The other ones, the blue and the black, they seem to be sold out. They only produced, I believe, 1,200 of each color. At least that's the information I saw, so they're pretty limited. They're pretty cool. They're decent. I would probably say seven out of 10, six and a half out of 10, something like that. They're pretty decent. They handle pretty good. Very simple. If you like NLCs, you're gonna like these even better because they got a nicer color palette, if you will, and B stock. Can't go wrong with that. And I think they're a little bit nicer than NLCs. They actually got a nice little border detail. No stupid, silly markings. So that is that. Comment, rate, subscribe. Let me know what you think. Check out collectiblepointcards.com where you can find these decks. Use the code VITASA32. It's just decent fanciness here. Fanciness. Now I'm making up words. I hope all of this. Let's move on. So that's that. Comment, rate, subscribe. We'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. And again, collectiblepointcards.com. Use the code VITASA32. Save, save, save.